We are all bankrupt. But I think you already knew that. No? Hasn't happened to you just quite yet? Wages are falling off of a cliff. And do not think for a split second that the government and the Fed does not have a secret little plan going on. So in this video, I'm going to give you the macro and I'm going to give you the micro. So that way, because that's kind of like what's happening to you right now. It's like, God, it doesn't feel like 95% employment right now. I do feel like I'm having to work a lot harder and making a lot less. That's macro. And coming in from Bloomberg, Merry Christmas. U.S. bankruptcy. What do you get today? Hey, look, Mom, I got a bankruptcy. What you get, Papa? I got no job. What you get, Grandma? I got stimulus. Yay! U.S. bankruptcy tracker. So they say it's the... But is that really what it is? Sparks worst December since 2011. Truth is, no! The government sparks worst December since 2011 because you said stay home for many of years. And it looks like a range of companies cited the in filings this month. And real estate companies just can't keep up from all you guys not paying your rent. And this month, right now, we got 16 large and in charge companies filing for bankruptcy protection. Too bad you couldn't be on the side of the airlines where, here you guys go. Like my daughter, who gets to sit around and get paid for doing absolutely nothing. Make her airline furlough over. There we go. Did flight attendants get jobs back thanks to the stimulus package? The truth is, yes. Why is that? Well, because the Fed can just paper over all of the problems. But if you pull back and look at the big picture, and you go Casper, so my face is not, looky there. Government worker wages and salaries have changed. Now, is that for the good or for the bad? I'm going to draw a little trend line. Isn't that nice with stocks and just about everything? You could just kind of trend it, right? You, my friends, no matter how you feel or look, or I mean, you feel and you look great. Honestly, I probably need to come back on camera to look at you directly in the face to say Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. It's almost funny saying that. Hey, let's meet in New York and we can watch the ball drop. But your money is less. It's just the way it is. Your salaries, what you're making is less. But it's not like a one big shabam, like, oh, I just took a big pay cut. No. It's over a long period of time. You got your wages going down and you got something else going down. And we're going to call her Fred. That's who's going down. Here we go. Let me take a look. Here is, ta-da, we'll go since 2000. You know, how far back do you want to go? It really doesn't matter. The trend is your friend until the very end is your purchasing power. When they give you... They're like, here, just take it, shut up. 600? Oh, you didn't like 600? Okay, how about 2,000? You gonna shut up then? No riots, please don't riot. Don't come to our gated communities. And actually, the only time that your purchasing power actually is more gooder is, the Great Depression. You got some purchasing power. Those are during our depressions or recessions is, let me move this over here. Good old 2008, right there. You started to have a little bit more purchasing power. But, right, print, that all goes away. And now, I mean, you're not even showing that. Are you even showing that right now? I got a Casper myself. And I'd have to say that kind of sucks, right? Everything's going to the poopers and you don't even have more purchasing power during a recession. You started to, right? March, here's some cash. Yeah, there we go again. But bravo, we are out of this recession. If you know anything about economics, which I don't, I just have a master's degree. I teach college and high school business. Okay, so I just know a little bit. I know that recessions are two quarters, right? That would be the beginning of the year. We think probably February. We're actually going into it before the, I don't know, maybe the powers that be were like, let's pull it. Pull the lever, Tom. So we had the first quarter, and then we had the second quarter. Those were a recession. And then the third one, we pulled out of it, right? Here. Here's some cash. Go spend it. Whew, we got out of it. But I say, according to whom? If you want to base recessions and depressions on this, on who created this system, that's a test at the end of this course, at the end of the channel, I'm going to give you a test. That would be Keynesian, John Maynard Keynes, to be exact. He said, if we, according to what a depression is just a declining growth, is this guy with a cute mustache. John Maynard, go to, get in here, Maynard. John Maynard Keynes. And we have been, I think since about the time I was born, 70s, 80s, we're 3% growth, right? That was normal. Now we only have 2%, low 2% growth. So in his book and in my book, that's a depression. And do you think it's going to get any better? Not based on the Keynesian system, it's not. And the only solution that our government or the Fed has is just print more. Sounds like a great, great solution. And tax more. Oh, okay. That's a good one too. And they just pray. The Fed just prays every day. They get down on their little knees and they're like, please, please, people, take out loans and get more credit cards. But you guys aren't doing that. Oh, did you click that? Okay, thank you. I like you too. You're not doing that. You're not applying for credit cards. Actually, when the government gives you money or they gives you digits, you keep paying off your credit cards. You hoard it. You save it. You buy Bitcoin. Like, this is not stimulating an economy, people. And then to topple this problem, the banks aren't lending. Well, I guess I wouldn't either if I saw this huge avalanche a-coming. I remember lending money to people on Lending Club, Prosper. Didn't make any money doing that. Don't do that. I would highly not recommend that. That's kind of like the government's doing right now. The banks, that's where money is created. You walk into a bank, I want a loan, $1 million, poof, $1 million created on a balance sheet. Yay, they have an asset, and then they can loan from that. Crazy, and then I take that $1 million, put it in someone else's bank, they're like, oh, we got $1 million too. Great, isn't that a great debt-based system that actually works out pretty well in the beginning? But now you guys are experiencing what is happening towards the end of this debt-based system. But I have many of solutions for you. But before we do that, I have to keep making this sandwich because we have doom, okay, and we have gloom. So one moment. So included on your doom and gloom sandwich is rejection. I think that's goes in the middle of this sandwich. You guys, if you think that you're going to apply for a credit card, guess what? You're gonna get rejected. Applications are actually down. You guys aren't getting out there. You're not feeling the risk. Not into the match.com, the dating game, where your friends or your buddies are like, bro, she's really ugly. And you're like, I'm feeling confident now. You walk over to her and she's like, yeah, I don't think so. Gentlemen, even if your confidence is still up, your pants are down and you're wearing Crocs. Like when you go up to that said lady, that said senorita, make sure your zipper is up and not down. Well, this is a business channel, but my friend, you do not have a license to sell hot dogs. Also, it's very unattractive. You don't even have a job, bro. You had a job. The mall, that's all you had. Now, look at this. Man, everywhere. My mall, your mall, retail, apocalypse. I wonder, could this be a created event? Or is it just me in Los Angeles and New York and anywhere there seems to be people? Just like Marketplace Mall in Rochester, New York was empty and many stores were closed. Thousands of stores have closed. Malls were struggling. This is like the biggest time of the year is Christmas. This is when Santa and his little elves like me, my ears, my elf ears, we go around and we're like, ooh, Boost Mobile. We need a phone for Skyler. Then he'll never get a chick, right? He's like, oh, I got Boost. See, that's another thing, Skyler. When the girl's like, hey, what do you have? You're like, oh, I have Boost Mobile. And she was thinking about maybe she could co-op with you on her plan. That's not going to work. And I was actually really sad last week. I went to go to the Apple store at my mall with all, I'm like, okay, I see all the clothes, everything's closed, but I see the lights are on at the Apple store. No, the lights are on closed. Police officer standing there going, can I help you? I'm like, yeah, I edit on a PC. I'm a Mac guy. Okay. Android, but I do have Macs or PC. What do I have? I have iPhones on my plan. Don't even ask, right? Six kids, you know. A kid not having an iPhone is like you walking up to a hot chick's with Crocs on and your zipper down. I just thought maybe walking in and buying a big fat Mac, it'd hurry up my process, my speed, my upload, my editing time. But they wouldn't even let me buy one. I can't imagine that helping the economy. And here it is. How can we help you? Well, why don't you open rather than being closed the rest of your life? And also what's crazy is you guys are all, you follow this channel around the world. You're still using our dollar like never before. Non-bank debt by currency denomination. Look at that. Draw you little charts. The trend is your friend. Look at that. Until the very end, I can make it a more gooder. That's what I wanted you to focus on. See that? It's going this way. Keeps going. Off all the way up to me. So are we going to lose our currency status? I don't know. By the looks of it, not. How are we looking on the Dixie chick? The dollar, again, the trend is your friend until the end. I see my marker. I do not, I did not select it properly. You see this? That's not good. It goes right into my hair. But let's see. Let's just see if there is a possible pullback, an awakening happening in the DXY, our dollar, because that's what everyone uses. I'm going to say on the daily, be very careful because I do see right here, you see that reversal? See little green on the Mackers, the MACD? We had a cross and we did not close above that 9 for me. Not that I would trade this because again, the trend is your friend until the end. And kids, that's not a trend I want to play with. Not until we get above that 200, or at least this 200 right here. The blue line, all right, I'm back in it. And oh my gosh, when that happens, so many people are going to be slaughtered on the altar. Y'all that thought it would be cool to short the dollar. I don't know, man. Maybe something like Nikola. That would be good. Look at that. You guys took there was a big beating on that one. And also, before I forget, you guys only have like a day or two left, and then that holiday special that I'm giving both of my courses away for $200 and something will be gone. And then you'll say, hey, I saw that video. Can I have it? I'll say, mm-mm, no, you can't. So if you would like to learn how to trade, this is not financial advice, I have a course on it. And Amazon, starting a business. The 200 right here, am I trading this? Nope, I'm not. Would I consider getting in and out? I would, but there's so many other better trades out there. And you guys on Nikola just had your boo-hole holes handed to you just today. What are we down today? 10, 11%? What are you since this little sell indicator? Actually, we dropped below the 9. That's my out game. So if I'm going to say, let's just say here to here, you guys are down 42%. And I'm sure there's most, if not all channels are like, buy and hold. Stocks only go up. And then at the end of the day, I want you guys not to be worried about this. Retail bankruptcies. Right? Don't worry about it because you're going to have your own online business. You don't have employees. You just sell a single product. And definitely what I don't want you on is on this side of it where you're actually in the store working a job. And they're like, sorry, Bob, we have to let you go. Retail bankruptcies in 2020 hit the highest level in more than a decade. And experts say there's more to come. But Bravo, what's your solutions? Be like Hugo. Here, I'll show you a picture of Hugo. He died in 1870. But me being German and Hugo also being German, guess what he did? When the government rent around and printed lots of this, he said, okay, that's great. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take this said cheddar and I am going to buy assets. Assets feed you, liabilities eat you. And right now, you can get loans at, what, 2%? So for me, as much as I can, that's to me, it's free money. When you have interest rates between 0 and 2%, and I can buy assets and pay them back with, you know, this stuff, all day long. And this guy bought just about everything that were assets, companies that were assets. And then, you know, with, you know what happened in Germany, right? This stuff didn't turn out too well. And so he just was like, oh yeah, you want me to pay you back? Here's one little piece of gold. There, all my debts are paid. And then at the end of the day, you get to walk around with assets because that's what you want. You really don't, you don't need this. You don't need this. You need this stoof. You do need this stoof, but you don't, not so much this stoof, right? That's what you want. You want land. You want a fishing pole. You want a surfboard. You want water. You want food. You want Lamborghinis. Nah, you don't want Lamborghinis at all. No, you don't want to be that guy at all. You want things like maybe an insurance policy, like Bitcoin, assets. Because who cares if your digits in your account are really big, but you don't have stuff? You don't have assets? You're poor. And one other thing, see this? Nope, don't look that way. Look that way. See this? Britannica. Do not invest in things that are going to go away. For example, Britannica. Remember the books? Britannica, right? That's where all of the knowledge was found. That goes away because technology is going to eat it. So protect yourself with assets of technology. And they were actually eaten by a company that is free, right? That's what technology does. It's deflationary. Takes over everything. And the government is trying to do everything in its power to fix that. They're like, oh, you can't. You can't fix it. Sorry, government. So they're going to print. The jobs, you know, are going to go away. And at the end of the day, technology will win. And I think if Hugo was still around today, he would be buying technology. Back in the day, he was buying industrial. But Bravo, what was this guy worth? Well, let's see. Several millions. That was before World War I. So that dude's a billionaire. So for you guys, that's going to be doing things like this. That's technology. I actually did. You're like, no, you're saying to make a physical product. Well, you can. For me, that's passive income. I don't have to work. I did try take a swing at a software company for 5 years as a point of sale system where you can order everything. It's called Rewip, R-E-W-I-P. You can look it up on YouTube, where you order off your phone, you pay off your phone, you go pick it up. We were so far advanced. We were probably too far advanced. But you guys can make stupid cat things or look this. Tell me. That's why I have a course on it. Look at this. I have no idea what this guy is doing. Actually, see what he's doing. He's photoshopping a very bad image. Oh, that is so funny. You guys, really, that is so bad. Let's just take a stock photo and let's put our little thing on it. And then this one kind of caught my eye. I guess, right? That would be kind of handy. You have one of these things, magnetic wristband. Okay, that is not photoshopped. Good job. I like that. You have all of your images. Except that's Photoshop. Come on. You tried. Go ahead and send me your image. Oh, and you have a video. Yes, I do that too. Look at that. Is that Photoshop? Possibly Photoshop. I think I really need to do something about that arm hair. I'm just saying. And how much is a stupid thing, right? How much would that cost you? Honestly, guys, what's that cost? $1 to make? You're selling it for 15. What is this cat making? Let's take a look. $178,000 every single 30 days. So we have the problem and then we have the solution. The solution is start a business, something technology, please. Invest in something technology, please. Hence why I have two courses on it for $290-something that the price is going to go up. So on this channel, and I offer you, if you don't want to take it, don't. Just take my knowledge and then you can figure it all out. Our problem is technology is going to eat the entire world. It's going to eat business unless you're on the right side of it. Everyone is a consumer. That's not going to go away. People consume. It's just different consumption of products. But Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, whatever. Why did my button subscribe? Yeah, I didn't hear the click. It was like, woof. Psyched me out. Maybe I'll subscribe tomorrow, Bravo. Oh, I'll see you tomorrow.